is fitting reaction and fitting reaction. And friends, along with the explanation and mechanism of these three reactions, you will get super tricks in this video. So please watch this video completely. And this video is helpful for all the students who are preparing for examination of class 11, class 12 and JEE, NEET, CET, etc. Friends, please subscribe to my channel to get more videos related to chemistry and don't forget to press the bell icon to get the notification regarding new videos. And friends, already I have uploaded the videos of Sandmeyer's reaction and Finkelstein and Schwarz reaction. Please watch those videos also. It will be helpful for you. And friends, let us come to today's topic, Wood's reaction. Friends, Wood's reaction is a reaction of alkyl halides and is a preparation method of alkenes. In this reaction, two molecules of alkyl halides react with sodium metal in dry ether to give higher alkane. First, let me write the reaction. When two molecules of alkyl halides react with sodium metal in dry ether, then there will be formation of a higher alkane and sodium halide. Very simple reaction. You can remember this reaction by an easy way that there will be formation of a sodium halide and this R group and this alkyl group are attached with each other, that is formation of alkane. Let me consider an example. When CH3Cl chloromethane reacts with sodium metal, two molecules in presence of dry ether as a medium, then. So friends, look at here. What is happening in this reaction? R is the product. That means you can easily combine the two groups attached to halogen atom. That is, two groups attached to halogen atoms are combined with each other. RR means CH3CH3. Here RX means CH3Cl. So RR CH3CH3. So one product will be CH3CH3. Plus NaCl, NaCl. That is 2NaCl. It is the Wood's reaction. When two molecules of chloromethane reacts with sodium metal in dry ether, then the product will be CH3CH, that is ethane and sodium chloride. So friends, it is very simple reaction. Just combine the two alkyl groups attached to the halogen atoms and another product will be sodium halide. So friends, in examination, you can get the question in the form of 2CH3Cl plus 2Na. What is the product? Or simply CH3Cl 2Na or simply Na in dry ether like this. So, all the three reactions are Wood's reaction. And friends, in your examination, if you ask to write about Wood's reaction, then with a very brief explanation, if you write these two reactions, then you will get full mark. But you have to know some informations about the Wood's reaction, like mechanism of the reaction and the role of dry ether. Or what happens if these two groups are different. That means Rx and R dash X, or what will be the reaction if the X are different? Well, that means one is chlorine and one is bromine, like that. So you will get the answer for all these questions in this video. And first, let me consider the role of dry ether. Friends, first, just assume we are considering this reaction in water. This water is reactive with both the reactants. It reacts with alkyl chloride also. And as we know, sodium metal reacts with water vigorously to give NaOH. if you use water as a medium in this reaction. So, as an inert solvent, dry ether will be the perfect medium for Wood's reaction. So, we use dry ether. And then let me consider the mechanism of the reaction, and afterwards I will discuss different examples of Wood's reaction. So, let me consider the mechanism of Wood's reaction. It is free radical mechanism. There is another mechanism called ionic mechanism. But free radical mechanism is very popular one, so I will tell you that mechanism. In case of free radical mechanism of Wood's reaction, in the first step, sodium atom approaches the alkyl halide. This sodium atom donates an electron to the halogen atom of the alkyl halide, and there will be formation of the alkyl free radical. The first step, sodium atom loses an electron and there will be a formation of Na plus ion. Sodium atom donates this electron to the halogen atom of the alkyl halide. When this electron is donated to the halogen atom of the alkyl halide, there will be homolytic fission between the carbon and halogen atom. Actually, we are indicating this alkyl halide as RX, but there is a bond between a carbon atom and halogen atom. Here, homolytic fission takes place. That means both the fragments get one electron each in case of homolytic fission. But in case of heterolytic fission, there will be formation of a cation and anion. That means both the bonding electrons will go with the only one fragment. Here, each fragment gets one electron each. That means there will be formation of free radical, alkyl free radical and halogen free radical, R dot and X dot. This halogen free radical so formed accepts the electron from the sodium atom and becomes X minus ion. The alkyl free radical so formed accepts electron from the another sodium atom. Actually, in these reactions we are mentioning the molecules as one or two like that. But in the reaction mixture, there are so many atoms are there. Or if you look at this reaction, there are two sodium atoms. The free radical, alkyl free radical will accepts an electron from the another sodium metal or sodium atom to become alkyl anion or carbonium ion. So R minus Na plus. This alkyl anion so formed attacks the another molecule of alkyl halide from the backside of the leaving group. Through the SN2 mechanism, there will be formation of an alkene. Here, this R minus acts as a nucleophile and it attacks the alkyl halide from the backside of the leaving group X. So, X will be released and there will be a formation of a new covalent bond between the R and R. So, there will be formation of an alkene and NaX. It is the mechanism of the Wood's reaction, but here a possibility of another reaction is there. That is, two alkyl free radicals may combine with each other to form alkane. Here, alkyl free radicals are formed. Two free radicals, because free radicals are very very unstable species. So this reaction also possible. Here, in case of mechanism of Wood's reaction, first sodium atom donates an electron to the halogen atom of the alkyl halide and there will be formation of two free radicals, or this halogen free radical so formed accepts the electron from the sodium atom and becomes X minus. Then The sodium, the free alkyl free radical so formed will accept an electron from the sodium atom, another sodium atom, and becomes alkyl anion or carbonium ion. This alkyl anion so formed will attack the another molecule of alkyl halide and there will be formation of alkane. Or two alkyl free radicals may combine with each other to form alkane. It is the mechanism of Wood's reaction. Friends, let us consider some examples for Wood's reaction. Friends, at the starting of this video, I told you that Wood's reaction is a preparative method of alkanes. But generally, we can't use Wood's reaction for preparation of all the alkanes. For example, let us take the first member of alkane family, that is CH4 or methane. In case of Wood's reaction, the final product is RR. That means there must be at least two carbon atoms in the product. Then only for those types of alkanes only, we can use Wood's reaction as a preparative method. So, by using Wood's reaction, we can't prepare methane which contains only one carbon atom. Then, next member of alkane family, that is CH3CH3 or ethane. In case of ethane, what are the reactant material or reacting alkyl halides? We can break the bond here. RR, that is CH3X, CH3X are reacting with each other. And the free radicals forming in the case of preparation of ethane are methyl free radicals. CH3 dot are methyl free radicals. During the mechanism, two methyl radicals are interacting with each other to form ethane. Friends, ethane is the best product that can be prepared from Wood's reaction. There is formation of only one type of free radical, so we can get a very good yield of ethane or very good yield of product during the preparation of ethane by using Wood's reaction. Next member of the family, alkane containing three carbon atom, that is propane. CH3, CH2, CH3. Here, propane is unsymmetric in nature. That means we have to break the bond here or here. In case of Wood's reaction, the preparation of propane is a type of reaction where two different alkyl halides are reacting. That means RX and R dash X are reacting with each other and the free radicals are forming are methyl free radical and ethyl free radical, CH3, CH2 dot. When methyl and ethyl free radicals are reacting with each other, then we get propane. But friends, in case of preparation of propane, there are some side reactions are occurring. In the reaction medium, there are two types of free radicals, methyl free radicals and ethyl free radicals. So, along with the interaction between two different free radicals, there are possibilities of formation of ethane because of the reaction between two methyl free radical, and also there may be butane, that is CH3CH2 dot and CH3CH2 dot. So two ethyl free radical may reacting with each other to form butane also. So in case of preparation of propane by using Wood's reaction, along with the interaction between one methyl free radical and one ethyl free radical, there may be possibilities of interaction between two methyl free radicals for leading to formation of ethane, and two ethyl free radicals may reacting with each other to form butane. So there is a possibility of decrease in the yield of the expected product propane, and these three products are difficult to separate. That means here there is a very little difference in the boiling point of these three products, so we can't use general separation method like fractional distillation for the separation of these products. So for the preparation of propane or any unsymmetric alkane, Wood's reaction is not that much suitable. And next member of family, butane. CH3, CH2, CH2, CH3. Four carbon atoms means butane. In case of preparation of butane, ethyl free radicals are forming. CH3. Ethyl free radicals are forming. Two ethyl free radicals reacting with each other to form butane. In case of propane, there are two different free radicals are forming. So, there is a possibility of chain side reaction. In case of butane, even though only one type of free radical is formed, but there is a possibility of another side reaction called free radical disproportionation reaction. In case of free radical disproportionation reaction, one free radical acts as an acceptor and another acts as donor. For example, in case of ethyl free radical, CH3, CH2 dot and CH2, CH3. Here, two ethyl free radicals are there. In case of a free radical disproportionation reaction, one free radical acts as proton donor and another free radical acts as proton acceptor. Instead of H plus, Cl minus etc. may be exchanged. But in case of the Wood's reaction for preparation of butane, ethyl free radicals are formed and free radical disproportionation reaction is taking place between the two free radical, ethyl free radicals. So, when this carbon atom donates H plus to this free radical, there will be formation of double bond between these two carbon atoms, CH2 double bond CH2. And here, this carbon atom accepts one proton from this free radical. So, it becomes CH3 single bond CH3. CH3, CH2 dot, that means ethyl free radical. One free radical donates a proton to another free radical. So, there is a formation of ethene and ethane. Even though these side products are formed in very less quantity, but there is a formation of side products in case of Wood's reaction for the preparation of butane. So, here methane containing only one carbon atom is not prepared by Wood's reaction. Ethane is the best product that can be prepared from Wood's reaction. In case of propane or any other alkane containing odd number of carbon atoms or unsymmetric alkanes, the Wood's reaction is not that much suitable because of the formation of side products. And in case of some alkanes, the free radicals may undergo free radical disproportionation reaction. Friends, another drawback of Wood's reaction is for tertiary alkyl halides, Wood's reaction is not possible. For example, in case of this reaction, N-diether, when tertiary alkyl halides undergo Wood's reaction, then the elimination reaction taking place over the SN2 mechanism of Wood's reaction. In case of tertiary alkyl halides, elimination reaction taking place over the SN2 mechanism, because SN2 mechanism requires more activation energy because of the steric hindrance. So, we get alkenes rather than the Wood's product. So, it is major product and it is minor. Or we can say for tertiary alkyl halides, Wood's reaction is not possible. And let us take another special example of Wood's reaction. What may be the product here? Two halogen atoms are different. Even though for alkyl halides or RCl and RBr, in that are different, the Wolff's reaction is possible. Here, what may be the product? Instead of the chain formation like this, instead of chain formation, there is intramolecular Wolff's reaction is taking place. That means we get a product like this. Intramolecular Wolff's reaction is taking place and NaBr, NaCl are forming. It is a special example of Wolff's reaction. Friends, hope this Wolff's reaction is clear to you. Let's consider Wolff-Fittig and Fittig reactions. Actually, Wolff's reaction is a reaction of alkyl halides in which alkyl halides react with sodium metal in dry ether to give alkane. Here, two alkyl groups are attached with each other and there will be formation of an alkane. In case of Wolff-Fittig reaction, actually it is a modification to Wolff's reaction. Here, one aryl halide is reacting with alkyl halide to give alkyl arene. Here also, sodium halide is forming, or this aryl group attached to alkyl group. So, alkyl arene is forming. Then, in case of Fittig reaction, both are aryl halides, or aryl halides are reacting with sodium metal to give an analogous product. Or here two aryl groups are attached with each other, like diphenyl etc. are forming. So in case of Wolff's reaction, both are alkyl halides. Here one is aryl halide, another is alkyl halide. In case of Fittig reaction, both are aryl halides. These are the three important reactions of alkyl or aryl halides. And trick to remember these three reactions is, after the feeding of accelerator, Wolff bought Benzcar. What is that sentence? Actually, if you understand this sentence, then you can easily write all the three reactions. Here, after the feeding of accelerator, Wolff bought Benzcar. What is the common thing in all the three reactions? That is halogen atom X. So, I am writing X here instead of ACC. Accelerator reminds you about the halogen atoms in these three reactions. And after the fitting of accelerator, Wolff bought Benzcar. Actually, Wolff want to buy a second-hand Benzcar, but there is a problem in the car. So, problem in the accelerator. So, after the fitting of accelerator, he bought that Benzcar. After the fitting of accelerator, that means whenever in the name of reaction that is Fittig, then you can easily write the benzene ring. After the fitting only, Wolff bought Benzcar. That means whenever the name of the reaction contains the word Fittig, a name of scientist, then only you can write the benzene ring or aromatic compounds. So, after the fitting, this fitting is for Fittig, Wolff-Fittig or Fittig reaction. After the fitting only, Wolff bought Benzcar, Benz for benzene ring or aryl halides. So, here X is for halogen atom and fitting for Fittig, Wolff's reaction, name of the reaction, Benz for benzene ring or aryl halides. So, after the fitting of accelerator, Wolff bought Benzcar. Is the trick to remember Wolff's reaction, Wolff-Fittig reaction and Fittig reaction. Friends, hope this video is so helpful for you. Please like this video and share this video with your friends. Please put your opinion in the comment section and please subscribe to my channel to get more videos related to chemistry. Thank you.